Got me all excited now. I'm more excited than the match. It was boring.
Exactly. Nah. All right. Hi, Zellsis. So first of all, congratulations on the big win. You were hella nasty on the Viper. Especially
thank you
went up against your boys from C9. How do you feel, and what does this win mean to you?
I mean, it's kind of nice that, you know, I can leave Sentinels, go save C9, and then let Sentinels know that they needed me. And now it's obvious that C9 needs me, so it feels pretty good. But this win was really good. We're coming for blood this split. You know, I think a lot of people were kind of on our name last split, and I think we were just a little tired. We were a little out of it, but now we're ready and we're showing it. So this win was really, really fun, really good.
Yeah, like, you guys showed an insane form today. And, you know, speaking of last split, like, this team looks revitalized and are in such great form right now at stage two. Do you think it was a blessing in disguise that you guys had more time to relax and prep than go through another Masters run before Champions?
For sure. I hate saying it as a competitor because I just always want to go to every LAN. I want to win everything. I want to be perfect as possible, but obviously in the real world you can't do that. So I think it was a blessing in disguise for sure, that, you know, it gave us a lot of time to really come together as a team, really revitalize like our comps, our strats, everything like that. We had a little bit more time to add flexibility, so it was good that we didn't make Shanghai. And I think now, like, a couple of these teams, I mean, G2 is not looking they're not looking tired. Those guys are pissing me off. I think it was good that we didn't go to Shanghai. We got to focus on champs, and I think we're showing it now.
Yeah, and we're definitely excited how you guys are gonna bring the fire to Shanghai. So wait, let's do a quick throwback real quick. Let's look back on your Madrid run, specifically during the grand final in Icebox against Gen.G. Everyone saw how eager Sentinels wanted that win. But you shined the brightest, and you showed how badly you wanted that win. Do you ever go back to that moment and channel that Zellsis in every match you have to go through now?
I think it's a psychological thing. Like, I've had those, like, moments or, like, mind thoughts where I'm like, I always have, like, one map where I'm good for, like, just to carry. Like, every series, I always have one good, really good map, especially, like, a BO5. I hope people don't go back and quote me on that and try to find like a BO5 where I'm just absolutely terrible, but they probably will. So screw you guys. But I try to play the same exact way every time I play, or not like the same exact way, but have the same intensity and everything like that every time I play. And I think sometimes it just, because I'm doing the right things, or I think I'm doing the right things at least, I may not be doing the right things, but I hope I'm doing the right things. And I think sometimes it's, you know, it's those gimmies. It's like, I think it's all just like the repetitiveness of like doing the same things and making sure you're drilled and, you know, consistent and everything like that. And I think that's why I have like certain maps where I'm just like, I kind of pop off like that, yeah.
And we saw it today on Split, like, you carried his Viper, insane.
I'm gonna miss Split so much, no.
I know. It'll be gone in 2 weeks. God.
Yeah, I'm so sad.
But, okay, so let's go to your Vibe Merchant era. Like, you are someone who brings so much energy and frags to the team. What helps you gain that unbreakable mental to get the team back in its flow state, especially if you guys have bad days or when faced with such tough opponents?
I think it's just because I have to do it, right? Like, if I don't do it, you know, maybe my team... If me doing it makes my team win 5% more, 10% more, 50% more, like, that's good for me. Like, I just want to win. And if my team doesn't like what I'm doing and they tell me and it's not allowing us to win, then, you know, I'll chill out or I'll stop or, you know, whatever the case may be. I'm adaptive. But for now, I think having vibes on a team, having that team chemistry, everything like that, having like a troll clown guy on the team, it just loosens things up for people. You know, they still think about the game, but they're not as tense. They're not, you know, maybe they're holding their mouse differently that day because they're tense or they're thinking about the match or the pressure or stuff like that. And then, you know, here comes the clown vibe merchant just yapping his ear off. Unk over here, just talking in the mic. And then, you know, maybe they relax a little, maybe, you know, something like that. And I think I bring a lot to the team for sure. I think every team I've been on, like, I think I have I didn't have a trophy before Sentinels, this year of Sentinels, which shout out my current teammates now, but I've always think I brought something to my teams that I've joined. And I think people are still seeing it here where, you know, I'm trying to make sure everyone's disciplined. I'm trying to, you know, make sure we're doing all the right things. You know, we're not like we're kids, but we're not being kids, you know, like, exactly. Yeah. So I think that's just about it.
Yeah. And I think Kaplan previously mentioned in an interview that you're not afraid to call out the team. Like, if they have to wake up, they gotta wake up. So,
yeah.
As someone who put in all the work, which has certainly paid off, you mentioned in one of your latest videos that you've been a big esports fan since you were 12. How does it feel to finally turn that dream into reality? And what does the future of Zellsis look like in the esports scene?
Ooh, I mean, I just love doing what I do. Like, I love being on stage. I love talking to the fans. I love competing. I love interviews. I love the content. I just love all of it. It's like, it's just something to be a part of that, you know, is growing so much and so big. And it's like, it's just amazing and a blessing to be able to do what I do. And for as long as I've done it. And the future, I hope one day when I'm done playing, I don't think I'll go into coaching. I've heard a lot of people say, I think they think that I'd be a good coach. Even coaches I've worked with and stuff like that have said I'd be a good coach, but I don't think I could do it. I definitely don't think I could. I respect all the coaches out there that can watch VODs for 8 hours a day, but I don't think I can do that. Yeah. And I think so in the future, I'd like to go into management. I'd like to personally myself own an org at some point, run things, be like an advisor ahead of things. You know, I'm not rich by any means, so I'll need, you know, a little bit of help if any billionaires out there want to. Yeah, some funding, you know, I'm big in the esports scene, you know, I definitely want to keep pursuing esports when I'm done playing. And I know that sounds like I'm retiring soon. I'm not. I promise. I'll play for as long as I can. But I definitely want to own an org or, you know, work in management somewhere. But owning an org and being able to house like a bunch of esports teams and be able to, you know, root for them and everything like that, that would be a blessing for me. So that's something I would like to chase in the future.
We're honestly really excited to see more of you in the esports scene. And well, lastly, what is one thing that people on the internet maybe misinterpret about you, do you think?
I don't think people misinterpret this. Like, I'm definitely a troll and I kind of say some stupid shit, but I think that's just me. It's not I mean, I'm not the perfect human, not the nicest guy, but I definitely think it's just, I'm just real. And I think people are starting to see that more and more. I mean, I still have haters. I have a couple names of haters, and I know you'll know that I know that you'll know, but I love you anyway. It's great. It fuels me. I just want people to, you know, turn like really negative hate into like kind of criticism, because I think the world has a little bit too much hate in it. I definitely think there needs to be criticism, and there needs to be not a little bullying, but a little bullying, you know. No one gets some tough skin without some bullying. So, but I think the overall hate is, and I think the Valorant community has been doing really well about that, honestly, like understanding the pro play, the pro personalities, things like that. So it's really good. I'm really glad to see that from the community. But for me, I mean, I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing, to be honest. Like, I'm not gonna change. I've been me. I'll always be me. So love me or hate me, I'm still getting paid. So yeah.
Facts. That is just facts right there. All right. Well, thank you so much, Zellsis, for your time today.
Thank you.
It's been such a pleasure. I'll see you in your streams.
Ooh, thank you.
Yes.